So in this video, I'm going to talk a little bit about the types of assignments and the kinds of materials you might use to complete this course. So with regards to assignments, there's a couple of different types of assignments in this class. There's the quizzes, which are interspersed throughout the units. They're typically 2 to 3 questions, just kind of a little bit of a checkup to make sure that you're paying attention, you got the basic concepts from the previous videos and things along those lines. I'm going to create them roughly one per every subunit, but you know there might be subunits like this one actually that don't have them in them. On the other hand, we might have some other types of assignments that fill their place, which we'll talk about. Then there's also the tests. The tests appear at the end of every unit. They're longer than the quizzes, and both the quizzes and the tests may require a little bit of model running or programming, especially as we get to the later sections of the course. Early on, obviously, they'll focus on conceptual questions, but they may require you to do a little bit of work in order to successfully complete those assignments. Finally, and probably in one case, I think most importantly, is the final project. And this will be a project that you'll be working on throughout the entire course, and it's due at the end. In fact, I want you to start right now. I want you to think a little bit about a particular phenomenon of interest to you that you would like to study through the use of agent-based modeling. Now, you might change your mind a couple of times. I don't want you necessarily to stick to the one that you're just thinking of right now. But, you know, as you learn more and more, you may figure it out. And along the way, I'm going to have what I call checkpoints. These are different points where we're going to have something concretely for you to think about, for you to develop, for you to kind of help construct that model. And as a result, the project will be developed over the entire course and due near the end of the course. So to help you out with this, of course, we have a set of software that we're going to use throughout this course. The first piece of software is something you've already probably taken a look at. It's something that we talked about in the first subunit, which is NetLogo, right? NetLogo is a freely available open source agent-based modeling toolkit developed by Uri Wilensky, and we're going to talk a little bit more about where it comes from and why it's important in the next units coming up. But essentially, if you haven't done so already, I highly recommend that you go to the NetLogo website, go through the tutorials, download the software, of course, install it on your machines, because we're going to be using it pretty heavily throughout this course. And NetLogo is available on any platform. It's on PCs, it's on Macs, it's on Linux, so you can get it working in just about every environment. It's going to look, you know, pretty much the same too as well. They've done a very consistent job on it. In addition to that, we'll also be using just a little bit a package called R. R is a statistical software package. Primarily, my goal there is to introduce you to how to take data that you've created from your models in NetLogo, import it into R, and do some basic statistical analysis. Now, this is not an R course, right? This is much more of an agent-based modeling course. So I'm not going to go into a lot of detail about how to actually analyze the data once you have it in R, but I do want you to see how you can bring it in and work on it. You could, of course, use other agent-based modeling languages. You could, of course, use other statistical software packages to complete this course. But these are the two that we're going to be using throughout the course and that we're going to be using for examples of it during the course. So probably if you want to stick to what we're doing, it's probably best to use these two pieces of software. In addition to the software that we'll be using throughout this course, I highly recommend picking up a copy of An Introduction to Agent-Based Modeling, written by me and Uri Wilensky, who is the lead author on this textbook. This textbook is available both at MIT Press and at Amazon, and I have the link right here for the MIT Press website about it. The book is in many ways a complement to this course, this online course, and it'll be able to go into a lot more detail and provide you with a lot more interesting insight into agent-based modeling than what I'll be able to do during these short video lectures. In addition to where to purchase the book, you can also find some more information about the book at www.introtoabm.com. That's where Uri and I post additional materials we might have for the book, as well as if we notice any small typos or things like that, we'll post any corrections up there as well. And we'll also put any additional information about the book available there. So I highly recommend picking up a copy. You definitely don't need it to complete this course in any way, but it will be very much an aid to the course as you go through it. So this actually brings me to your first assignment. It's just not one of those little quick multiple choice quizzes. Basically, I want to know who you are. I want to get into understanding why you're taking this course, what your interests are in, whether or not you consider yourself to be a computer programmer or an expertise in modeling and or anything along those lines. So right now, on the next segment, we'll have a link to a participant poll where you can help us understand a little bit better about who you are. Now, this is different from the survey that Complexity Explorer will be sending out, where they try and get a idea of what the various people who are attending the course are. This one is tailored specifically to this course and will help us understand your interests and your angles for this. So go ahead and complete that right now. And in the next subunit, we'll start to dive into what agent-based modeling is all about.